Another of his students was Wernher von Braun, a German and later American engineer, who led the development of rocket technology in Nazi Germany, and later became a pioneer of rocket and space technology in America. It happened because at the end of the Second World War, hundreds of German scientists, engineers and technicians were taken in by the United States to become government employees, despite the involvement of some of them in the Nazi regime, because their know-how in different fields, including rocketry and aerospace, was seen as of strategic importance to America, and also to avoid that they fell into Soviet hands, because in 1945 it was already obvious that the US-USSR rivalry was going to be a thing. But we will also come back to this later, when I tell you about the space race during the Cold War. This program to take in German scientists was called Operation Paperclip, and Wernher von Braun was its most prominent figure. He would play a crucial role in America in the development of ballistic missiles, and after 1960, as the architect of the rocket that sent the Apollo spacecraft to the moon, the Saturn V rocket. He was not alone in this, obviously. The American space program employed hundreds of theoreticians, engineers, technicians, astronauts. But he was certainly one of the fathers of rocket science and space travel in the 20th century.